Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I want to talk about how to calculate your grade point average. A grade point average could also be called a weighted mean, meaning some classes will have more of an impact or weight on your GPA than others. This will depend on the number of credits for each class. A 1-credit class would have less of an impact than a 5-credit class. In order to calculate your GPA, you need to assign a point value to each grade. I have made up fictitious point values in the chart below. It will be up to you to visit the school's website and find out the actual scale used at your institution. From this chart, you can see that an A is worth 4 points, while a D plus is worth 1.30 points, and so forth. Let's take a look at an example of a transcript someone might have. They have taken 4 different classes, but each class has a different number of credits. What I want to do is figure out the number of points they earn for each class. To do that, I need to look at that point scale that I had. So I'm going to take the number of credits of the class, and I'm going to calculate, why is that jumping? I'm going to calculate the number of credits times the point value of their grade. And so this grade was an A minus. The point value is going to be 3.70. And if I multiply 2 times 3.70, I get 7.40. So that's the total points for that particular class. I'm going to do the same thing for each class. The next one would be 5 points, and this one was a B plus. And a B plus in my point scale, remember this is fictitious, was 3.30. And so if I multiply 5 times 3.30, or 3 30 hundredths, I get 16.50. Notice in every number I'm going out to the 2 digits because that's how GPA is calculated, and it's always presented out to 2 places past the decimal point or the hundredths place. For keyboard or for English 98, they had 5 credits again. And this time they had a C, which is worth just 2 points. And 5 times 2 was going to be 10. In this case, I'm going to write 10 and 0 hundredths. And then for keyboarding, it was a 2-credit class, but they had an A. So they have 2 credits, and the A is worth 4 points, so we get 8.00. And now what I want to do is add up the number of credits that they attempted for the quarter. That's the total down here. Well, the total number of credits attempted was 14, and I want to add up the points, that is 7.40, 16.50, 10, and 18. And I did that already earlier, so I know what that is. And that equals, when I add those together, I got 41.90. So what I did was I figured out the points for each of the classes, and then I added up the total points earned, and I added up the total number of credits. We need to find the average number of points earned per credit. So we divide the points earned by the number of credits. So let's do that. We're going to take 41.90 and divide by 14, because we're taking the points earned divided by the credits attempted or the credits completed. And what we always want to do is round that to the hundredths place. But when I first do this on my calculator, I got this 2.992857, I'm going to say dot, dot, dot. It went on for a while. So when you see a grade point average, you want to assume that it might have been rounded off in a way that changed it a little bit. But that's what we accept that. So I'm going to say approximately, those 2 wavy lines mean approximately, out to the 2 places is 2.99. So this person would have an approximate GPA of 2.99 at the end of that quarter. All right, have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time.